Hello, everyone. My name's Robert Hugh Morgan. I'm the university organist at Stanford University, and I'm delighted to welcome you to this week's lunchtime recital. Our journey through the season of Lent with the music of Johann Sebastian Bach has now arrived at Easter. So today, a program of two great chorale preludes, as well as two of Bach's most majestic and joyful works. To begin, the Alla Breve. Indeed, the word alla breve referring to the time signature of two half notes to the bar. This piece is a majestic unfolding of some intricate counterpoint, but it's a piece of incredible strength, and I think it's a fabulous counterpart to the De Non Nobis Pacem from the B minor Mass, a piece to which it bears strong similarity. We then move on to the chorale prelude for Easter, Christ ist erstanden. This is an extraordinary piece in that he sets three different verses of the same chorale, each verse growing in scale and scope from the previous one. I do think this is a fabulous work. It's a work of sheer drama and architecture. The following chorale prelude is actually a fantasia on another Easter chorale prelude, Christ lag in Todesbanden. There are many elements in this work that point towards it being a homage to such composers as his teachers, Georg Böhm and Dietrich Buxtehude, both of whom wrote chorale fantasias. Bach's work certainly contains all that you might expect to find in a chorale fantasia by these two older composers. Many varying sections, changes in texture and rhythm, echo effects, and so on and so forth. To conclude, the Magnificent Prelude and Fugue in G major. We're lucky that there's an autograph copy of this work, so we definitely know that it's an authentic work. However, there's some confusion over whether or not it was written while he was in Weimar, but that's a minor problem. The prelude begins with vigorous 16th notes for the first 11 bars, all outlining the tonic key of G major. Then the piece continues with fanfare-like chords and scurrying 16th note pedal lines. The fugue is very, very interesting because of the great number of repeated notes in the subject heard right at the beginning. One might surmise that this would chain the composer down somewhat to a limited harmonic palette. Oh, but no, quite the opposite. It's a work of great inventiveness, which comes to a really dizzying moment when everything stops on dissonant chord. And after silence, it all takes off again and leads to a majestic conclusion. A great fugue, truly. All of what you're hearing in these recitals are performances which are recorded at Memorial Church, some of them at Sunday morning services, some of them at evening concerts. So if you hear background noise, that's why. I do hope that you enjoy listening to this great music. Thanks so much for listening. Be well, take care, and stay healthy.